Okay, good good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Great. It's good to be here. This is my, I think, third or fourth time in Aba. So it's not my first time. Okay. Even though I can't speak the language, you know, when I'm dealing with my Igbo brothers in Lagos, because they deal with us a lot, you have to pick a few things, Abi.
Yes.
So, Kekine.
Adoma.
Kemakalo.
Onaga.
That's where I know Rachel. But good afternoon. It's an honor to be here. And like they said in the citation, I really enjoy sharing with people that are interested in the fashion industry, being young or old. I'm not one of those that put age barrier in anything at all in life. And the key thing is that we share. It's hard because I can't do it on the one-on-one with everybody. I wish I could, but there are just too many people that want to ask me questions, and it's just one of me. So it's always very challenging. So today is going to be your show and not my show, okay? So I'm not going to come here for the education for me. I went to Edo State University in Ekpoma. I studied Agric Economics. I went to City University in London where I did a master's degree in Information Systems and Technology. When I was done, I came back home to Nigeria and I worked for two multinationals. I worked for British American Tobacco. Worked there for about 4 years and a bit. Then I moved on to Diageo, which is Guinness, Nigerian PLC. And I worked there for about 4 years and a bit. So one of the few times I came to Aba then was when I worked for Guinness to come and check how things were going on here when we were selling our Guinness stout. It was while I was in Guinness I started doing fashion, okay? I did fashion with my job for 3 years. So I was working full time and also doing fashion. So when people talk about you do not have time, I say you're just giving another excuse. Okay? When there's no time to work, then don't sleep. Use sleep time to do some work. So I worked a very challenging role as the senior brand manager for Guinness. And every time that I close from work at 6 or 7 o'clock, I go to my factory and I start manufacturing clothes for customers. Sometimes till 1 or 2 a.m. And I get ready to go back to work. I go to work at 7 o'clock every day because I lived on the other side of Lagos. And I did that for 3 years. But it didn't feel like work to me because I enjoyed doing what I was doing. So in 2010, I took a break or I quit my job and decided to face fashion full time. Now, the difference between doing it when I had a job and doing it when I didn't have a job was night and day. It was like two different things. Okay, it was more challenging that I even have more time. Then I started seeing things I could do better. I started trying to improve on those things. And that's how the journey started. So when I started, I didn't want to be a women's wear designer at all. I went to do only men's wear. I just felt like women had too much wahala. But we loved them anyway. So, but I was backstage a TV reality show and I had to make clothes for a lady. She's an ex-beauty queen. And I made a few things for her in the dance show. Then afterwards I started making things money on your idea. It is literally useless. I tell people that the best fashion designer may actually just be in a bank working right now. He's probably the best fashion designer. But because he has not put out his work and people have not acknowledged it, he's still going to be a banker. And even though you're amazing, I'm the best, but people do not call you the best, then you are not the best. Because we're in the business of making money. Fashion is like any other business. You're a manufacturer, right, of goods. And you also provide services. Because you can be the best tailor and your attitude sucks, people will not come to you. So you have to have a good balance of both. So it's not about how you look, how well you design, it's not about that. It's how you sell what you do to your customer, how you keep your promise. You know, we all have the bad names as tailors. All of us have bad names as tailors. I always say that these people, You will give them. Now there are Christmas memes coming out that tell us they're having meeting on how to disappoint people throughout Christmas. Right? But that was how my journey started. And a lot of things that I did, I learned them as I was going on. I've not been to a fashion school full time. I've only spent 4 weeks in a fashion school in Italy. 4 weeks. And those 4 weeks are not full weeks. It was Monday to Thursday. Out of the 4 weekends that I had in Italy, 2 of those weekends, I came back to Lagos to come and work. Because I had the project I was doing in Lagos. Apart from that, I brought a master tailor from Savile Row in England. Savile Row is like the mecca of suit making. To come and train here twice. That's all the experience I have in actual tailoring and garment construction and pattern making. Every other thing I learned myself off the internet and out of being curious. I will still buy a garment so I can look inside and rip it apart and see how they made it. Till tomorrow. I would rather walk behind a fashion show to see other designers' pieces and try to understand the intricacies of the pieces. But you see, in what we do, there's something called fashion and fashion designing, which is your product. There's another thing called brand, which is how you sell your
everything, you know it. King already, you know it. Shine already.